What did liberal nationalism stand for from the sub-chapter Making of Nationalism in Europe? And the word is derived from the Latin root liber, meaning freedom. And in this para, it denotes ideas related with freedom of nation expressed by its people against the monarchy for a free nation. Nation freed from the monarchical rule. And in that period, for the new middle class, it stood for freedom of individual and equality of all before law. Because middle class people were successful at that period in creating wealth due to their own ability, and that is why they demanded equality before law, at par with the high society during that period. Politically, it gave the importance of government by consent. That means a government elected by the people. And during France Revolution, it stood for end of autocratic and clerical privileges. There were certain privileges that was enjoyed by the first state and second state. So it should be removed, and there should be a constitution and government through a parliament. And in 19th century, it also gave importance of private property. That means it stood for owning property by citizens, not like the feudal system where certain class can only have land and property. And if we compare this meaning of liberalism after revolution in France, then the word liberalism had a limited options related with its citizens. And we can recall that in revolutionary France, which marked the first political experiment in liberal democracy, where right to property was granted exclusively to property owning men without property, and all women were excluded from political rights. Only for a brief period under Jacobians did all the adult male enjoy suffrage. And during Napoleon's rule, his court went back to limited suffrage and reduced women to the status of minor, subject to the authority of fathers and husband. That means the woman had this right to vote, but under the guidance of their fathers and husband. So, in 19th century and early 20th century, women and non-propertied men organized opposition movement demanding equal political rights. And in economic term, liberalism stood for the freedom of markets and abolition of state-imposed restrictions on the movement of goods and capital. Here, state imposed restrictions refers to taxes and custom duties imposed by the state of a certain region. And during 19th century, this removal of state imposed taxes and custom duties was a strong demand of the emerging middle class, because it created lots of problem for these traders, businessmen of the middle class. Let's take an example of the German-speaking region in the first half of 18th century, where Napoleon administrative measures had created out countless small principalities area under Napoleon. There were 39 states under Napoleon rule, and each of these principalities had their own government appointed by Napoleon. They had their own currencies, weight and measures. And while passing through these 39 states, the merchants, the traders had to pay taxes according to weight and measures of the goods. And this created a lot of obstructions for this commercial class, who demanded for a creation of unified territory, allowing unhindered, unrestricted movement of goods and capitals and people. And in the year 1834, a custom union was formed at the initiative of Prussia, and it was joined by most of the German states. And this union abolished tariff barriers and reduced numbers of currencies from over 30 to 2. And the creation of network of railways at that period further encouraged the mobility, unharassing, unrestricted economic interest for a national unification. And this economic changes that was demanded by the people created a wave of economic nationalism, which strengthened the wider national sentiment growing at that time.